So questions one and two. It says up here, questions one and two are associated with each other. A rock is thrown, you got your trebuchet kind of projectile. See, so that's a rock thrown from the edge of the cliff with an initial velocity of V0 at an angle theta with the horizontal as shown above. Point P is the highest point in the rock's trajectory, its path, and point Q is level, so it's like level with its starting point. Assume air resistance is negligible. That means it's in free fall. Only force acting on it, gravitational force, or its weight. So, question one. Which of the following correctly describes the horizontal and vertical speeds of the rock at point P? Hide the answers because that makes it a little bit easier. So, anyway, well, let's think about that. Just redraw this real quick. So you're looking at H max. Okay, so they want to know horizontal speed. Well, I do want to see this written on y'all's. Or you can do this on your drawing if you want to. I'm just drawing it. So look, you have your initial velocity, right? At angle theta with the horizontal. So hopefully you know, you got, when you have a V naught, when you have your initial velocity at an angle like this, it breaks up into your x and y components. So this would be Vx, horizontal speed, and this would be Vy, or that would be your initial vertical speed to start off with. And as you can see, this is a piece of your V0, and it is closest to your angle, cosine theta. And then so this one would be V0 sine theta. All right, so, but they asked at point P. So also, you know, acceleration is that way for the y direction, and ax equals zero. So if it's not accelerating in the x direction, every single point, no matter where it is here, it's kind of long, is going to be in the x direction, V0 cosine theta. Cosine theta, etc. All right, so that would be a horizontal speed. So here would be like h speed is V0 cosine theta. And that's because the acceleration is zero. Okay, your vertical speed at the top. Well, this is its highest point in the projectile. That's like whenever some of you ran to the end of the hall and tried to come back without stopping. This is where it begins to turn around in the y direction. So you can't turn around without stopping. Right here, Vy equals zero. So go like V speed. I'm just kind of filling this out over here. Speed would be zero, and acceleration. There is only one acceleration because air resistance is negligible. That means it's in free fall. That means the only force acting on it is its weight, and the only acceleration is acceleration due to gravity. So right here would be G. Let's see. Okay, so looking at that, V cosine theta. Hey, it's A. So that's question one. Now question two is associated with this one. So, well, it's like the same question, but at point Q. Which of the following correctly describes the horizontal and vertical speeds and the acceleration of the rocket point Q? Well, only one thing's going to change on this. See, we already have this. We already know the acceleration. Here's the thing. Since this is even with it, what you're going to get is your final velocity, since they're going from a same height, V0 is going to equal V in this case. It's just going to be in the opposite direction, but it says speed, so we don't really care about direction. So that means you're going to have your V0 cosine theta here. I already wrote that. And you're going to have whatever your original y velocity was, except it's speed. So it doesn't matter that it's pointing in the opposite direction. These two are equal. So everything's going to be the same, except this is going to be V0 sine theta, because it's this is the same as this. So we're looking for V0 cosine theta, V0 sine theta. Yep. D for number two. And you need to see something written that's like compares these two. Your initial y velocity and your final y velocity at point. point cube.